I'm asking the question.
He's asking the question. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Oh, that's true.
What?
I worked for before the pandemic started. This is your first show after, no?
Yeah, 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 yeah. So, you who's see? Asking the questions? Okay, good. Okay.
How is that? Well, for me, it's quite special because the last show you did,
I was a showstopper.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
So I'm happy to be back. I'm happy that the shows and everything have started again. And I'm happy to be wearing your new stuff.
New collection.
No,
Me too. Me too. Because it's really nice to do a live show after so long. To get the whole feel of fashion. You just see a film and you never feel it. Yeah. But seeing people walk, story, theory, and most importantly, this is a fantastic story.
Yeah.
The show today is about the times we live in.
Yeah, so
I hope
exciting.
It's exciting for everybody. Next question.
What are you looking forward to for the show?
Don't ask me more questions. No, 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 no.
He's going to give it away. He's gonna give it.
What
are you looking forward to for?
Can I answer that?
Okay, go ahead.
So, Nari always has a special idea for whatever show, whatever new collection he has. And it's so unpredictable. And now it's two books, right?
And now it's two books. The second book is missing.
He's kind of put together into a whole new collection. And that's what I love about him, because it's so different than what other people do. So
each one to themselves.
Each one to themselves, but it's just so special. So I'm excited about that. I just want to know what you've done with these two books and a whole new collection.
So for me, it's really important. Clothes mean nothing without a story. Today, you want to wear a story. You want to tell a story. You want to tell a story before you walk into the place, you know?
Yeah.
This is what the world is about today.
Yeah.
It's not just about pretty and being dolled up, but who you stand for and what it means to you. And so our fashion, our show is exactly about this. It talks about two books written in 1931 and 1949.
Wow.
The books are called The Brave New World and 1984 by George Orwell. It's a dystopian picture of what they perceived the world to be 100 years from where they were living.
Yeah.
We are living it today.
Wow.
So this is the world that we are living in today. This show is about today. A lot of things that people don't see is what we do with our show.
Okay, talking about your collection, what will your collection be?
So the collection is sort of sporty, athleisure, Instagrammable, young people. And it's about young people today, you know. It's not about, of course it's not wedding wear. Definitely. It's not another Dulhania show.
Hey, I can wear this to a wedding.
I know, you can. You can wear anything. So it's not another Dulhania show, but this is really about clothes that you can wear every day and look cool, go to the club, be seen, mix it with different things, tell a story. Like what she's wearing right now is graffiti from the 1980s in New York. And graffiti was a way of how people protested, told
Express
a story. So
yeah.
This is what we're doing with the show.
Well, as I said before, every collection is very special. Every collection has a story to it, a very profound story, which is like it has something to it, which makes it very, very special. So I'm actually always excited about his new launches, his shows and everything. So I also don't know much yet. I'm going to be watching it and then I'm going to know more and I'm going to know as much as you then.
But when it comes to clothing, what kind of clothing you wear? Like, what's your...
In clothing? What you see what I'm wearing is so me. I love pantsuits. I love these crazy colors. He knew. Like, I was like, Nari, send me 2-3 options. And he just sent me this.
One.
And it was perfect. He knows me, so that's me. What you see here is me.
Okay, I have to run now.
Yeah, the show
for the rehearsal. Bye-bye.
Thank you. Thank you, thanks. Thank you so much. Thank you so much. I felt beautiful, and I think I would say that 50% of my work was done when I wore the outfit, because it's a very stunning outfit. It's a very different color. It's a very different color, so that's why I think half my work was done. So then I could just enjoy, feel the music, and walk to that. It was very, very comfortable. It also comes with a dupatta, which I did not wear, thanks to them. And I think that made me feel even more comfortable. But it was a beautiful moment, yeah. On normal days, you'd see me, like I said, in my cargo pants and all my shorts and a t-shirt.
You're not wearing this every day?
Not... Maybe. That would be my workout for the day.
Yeah, I know,
if I wore this every day.
In and out, and out.
Yeah.
So, this collection was
fabulous.
Tell me about the collection.
So, the collection name is Teja, which is basically a goddess of marriages. The entire inspiration behind the collection was that we wanted to bring in something that was modern with a touch of a lot of tradition with it. So we've included a lot of velvets this time, which is very traditionally very royal and something very palace, very sort of queen kind of, right? But then we've sort of patched it up with a lot of very exclusive new colors and a lot of modern cuts to it, modern silhouettes as well. So it's been a blend of modernity and like, you know, sort of tradition in that sense.
Depends on the occasion. I mean, if it's a very close event, then of course I would like dress up heavier. But normally I'm always the more simple, classic kind of person. Yeah, I would go more simple and classic. Yeah. Not something in particular, but I have seen the brand everywhere, you know, on hoardings, and I've actually shopped at their store many times. So in fact, my cousin sister wore Kalki for her wedding, you know. So yeah, so it's been like, it's something I know. It's a brand I know, and I was happy to be a part of the brand.
I mean, as I told you, like in terms of the collection, like, you know, it's about that. And I think Pooja is really apt as the showstopper for that, because I think she brings in so much elegance and she's just so gorgeous, just any way. And she's looking stunning when she's wearing this lehenga. So, I mean, since it's like the goddess of marriages, I really think she just looks so stunning. It had to be her, you know, as the
showstopper. Yeah. I'm not only a model anymore, you know. So I do like to bring a little bit of drama when I'm walking the ramp. So whether it's blowing a kiss or winking as I did on the ramp, I like to bring a little bit of drama in it, yeah. Thank you so much. I know.
Yeah.
Oh, my fans are very excited right now, because I play a stand-up comedian in the film, and you know, the girl has a very strong, powerful role, which is why people are, you know, calling me for my performance. You know, a lot of people called me, a lot of producers, directors. They said that, you know, one is to have a glamorous person and one is to have a good performer. And after very long, we've seen someone, you know, come together. And I was like, are you going to make me cry before I walk the ramp? Because while I was doing my hair and makeup, I got so many calls. And I'm just over the moon, you know, with all the response that I've been getting. So I'm feeling blessed right now.
Besides this, you know, people have many
Yeah. Many. I have Acharya, I have Radhesham in Telugu, I have a film with Mahesh Babu which is gonna start. I have in Tamil, I have Beast with Vijay Talapathy, and in Hindi I have Circus and I have Bhaijaan. Yeah. Surya Vanshi. I mean, I'm doing Rohit Sir's next film, and we have that Shetty connection, so I'm excited for the film. I think it's gonna, you know, be such a breath of fresh air after the sad times we've had in COVID. So I'm excited for it. This Diwali, I just, you know, moved into my own house. So I'm hoping that I spend Diwali in my house, just decorate it, set it up, very excited. Somebody wanted it. This Most Eligible Bachelor is my first film that's released after COVID. Just before COVID, I had Alavaikunta Puramlu release, which was great because Butta Bomma just went like everywhere. So it was exciting. It was... yeah, so and then after that, now Most Eligible, I'm very happy it's doing well. Wish yours wishing everyone a happy Diwali. Thank you. Thank you.